Hey, as promised, back with another YouTube video here, probably the second one in 1 week. I'm Paul, if you didn't know, the owner of Black Iron Performance LLC. I'm actually wearing my own company t-shirt for once. And I also run the Instagram page over at Black Iron Gunner. The video I'm going to be doing today is on the Mark 18, probably the most iconic rifle here on YouTube and Instagram. Everybody knows what the Mark 18 is in 2021. It's super iconic, it's awesome. Anybody that's running SBR is probably running some style of the Mark 18. The first Mark 18, actual real Mark 18 I saw in real life was in a combat sing in Afghanistan 2011. It was on a rooftop. It was an SAS operator. The dude wasn't wearing any plates. For you guys that don't know what plates are, he wasn't wearing any body armor. He wasn't wearing a Kevlar, so something like this, a helmet. Wearing t-shirts. I think he had something like a chest rig on with some shorts, and he was just going to town. He had the two connected AR mags. It was pretty sweet. Not suppressed, but I think I have a video of it somewhere. But anyways, that was the first time I saw a Mark 18. Was instantly like, what is that? It's a 10-3 rifle, all right, from 2000 to 1999 or 2000, I think they were first brought in by Colt. It's been present all the way until now. And I figured, why not show you my Mark 18-ish rifle, all right? It's not exactly a Mark 18. Most of the ones you're seeing on the market today, or in reality, those are not real Mark 18s. But a Mark 18 basically is a barrel of a 10-3, all right? Something with a 10-3 barrel, short-barreled rifle. So let's go ahead and show you mine. If you guys don't know what a Seahorse case is, this is my favorite. It literally holds everything. Seahorse cases is awesome. They've sent me many of these, and I really like them. So before we get started, I know a ton of you are asked what's in this Seahorse case, or at least wondering. Primarily for this case is just mags, ammo, it's a variety of stuff. Sharpies, staple guns, Ear Pro, mag pouches, pasters, ammo, Vertex gloves. By the way, if you guys didn't know, I mentioned this in most of my videos, it's primarily my only source of income when it comes to social media, is through Vertex and Zev. But for Vertex, you know, they make great bags, they make great pants, like these Defiance jeans, and some of the bags they make, like this, which is the OD, what's that little character called? Baby Yoda. This is the Baby Yoda Vertex bag. This is something I carry my rifle in, or one of my rifles, one of my shorter rifles. This is the Gamut 2.0. And it's really cool for some of these bags, especially if you're running a loft holder like me. But let's get to the rifle. So for you safety Nazis out there, yes, I have triple checked, quadruple checked this rifle many times to make sure it's safe. And I'm just leaving the magazine in. You know, it looks a little bit cooler. All right. So we're gonna start from the top. We'll work our way down. I'll explain what I have on this rifle, what I'm using, why I like it, why I chose it. Possibly. There are also some other things that I have paid for in this rifle, and then some things that I have not paid for in this rifle. Any of those things, I'll let you know. This is like the first rifle that I've actually like paid for. A lot of the rifles I've got from like Ballistic Advantage, Shooting Surplus, Zev, those rifles I didn't pay for. All right, this rifle is something I built over time, kind of with my money and pieced together, and had a gunsmith here in Ohio put together for me, because I am not the most handy gunsmithy tinker guy when it comes to, you know, gas blocks and putting triggers in. I can do the basic trigger job and stuff like that, but beyond that, I just give it to a gunsmith. So we're gonna work our way from the top, and we'll go to the bottom. So from the top, most of you guys already know this is a Surefire suppressor. Now, this is not the RC2 Mini or RC2, this is a SB2, right? This is the one for like 10 and a half or 10 inch barrels and below. This is the one they had at the shop that I went to, Pro Armament here in Ohio. Shout out to them. Great guys over there. So this is why I went with this one. I didn't pick the SB2 over the RC2 for any reason. They just had the SB2 in stock, and really, in my opinion, they're not much different, but people can argue that. The muzzle device I went with is the Surefire Closed Tine War Comp. It's what I had laying around. Obviously, I needed a Surefire muzzle device to make sure I could, you know, attach my Surefire suppressor. Always have used Surefire suppressors, or excuse me, always have used Surefire muzzle devices. They've come on a lot of my rifles, and the other reason I went with a lot of them is because I have buddies that most have Surefire suppressors, so then I could, you know, run their suppressor if I want, like you'll see in this video right now.
Big breath.
All right, so done with the muzzle device and suppressor. The other reason I really like their suppressors are their lockup. All right, real QD, awesome. Okay, something you guys are looking at right here. For you that don't know, this is a full power pack 15. All right, this is for shooting with night vision. For you guys that do know, yes, this is a full power pack 15. So primarily you cannot buy this as a citizen. You need to be a law enforcement officer, not even just a law enforcement officer. You need to have your actual department order it, or you need to be the military to buy these. So, kind of sucks. Unconstitutional, yes. I think it's the FDA that's in charge of these. I get it, but I don't. For us guys that just want to have night vision, you know, full power lasers are the shiznit. You don't need one, but there are times where full power definitely is handy. So I had to buy this on the black market, unfortunately. These are about $2,000. And I'll also go through the prices. So the suppressor's around $1,000, I think I paid for it. Then you have a $200 stamp. So let's say $1,200. That muzzle device is like $120. And then this full power pack used, I paid $1,950. We'll call it $2,000 on the black market. Come over to our lumens here. I have a Surefire M600DF. All right, this is a dual fuel. I think these are around $230. And this is capable of putting out 1,500 lumens. Attached to that is a Surefire, I think it's the S500 possibly, switch. Now what I like about this switch is I've had some Surefire pressure pads go out on me before. This is like the first time that I've never had one go out is on this rifle. But just in case this does go out and let's just say I can't use it, what's nice is I can go ahead and have a pressure pad there as well, or a push button. So just in case for some reason my pressure pad's not working, what I do like is I still can operate the weapon light by using that button. So very, very nice. Attached to that M600DF is my T-Rex Arms light bar. Really cool. Cool guys over at T-Rex. They're awesome. The products that they are making are second to none. I use their holsters, their play carriers, their light bars, and a whole bunch of their other products. So shout out to them. I did get this one for free. So really good friends over there, social media friends, and that's how I met them, and it's really cool. So, awesome light bar. What I like about this, all right, so if I were to actually throw my M600 here on just maybe like an Arisaka mount or something, my light would only get to about here. Now, the problem is with that, when I went to activate my light, I would get basically a bunch of splash here on the suppressor. As you can see, I'm only getting about maybe an inch of splash, and I could still put this a little bit more forward. But that's what's nice about this. I can back it up and have it normal if I want. But what's really cool is if I want to go ahead and run that weapon light forward so I don't get the splash on the suppressor, I can do that. So that's a T-Rex Arms light bar. Running my switches to my, not only my laser and my Surefire light here, I have Mod Light Mod buttons, all right? I paid for these. They actually weren't too expensive, but they're kind of expensive for what they really are. They are what they are. Why I went with these is they're really slick, minimalist, and they're clean, and that's what I like. You'll see with this rifle, I like everything clean. I don't like shit hanging off of it. I don't like things in the way. All right, when I get my C-clamp on this rifle, I want everything out of the way. You'll see here, I don't want my wire snagging on any tree limbs or anything like that. So up front, this black one here, that's rocking my M600DF. This bottom one is rocking my laser. All right, you can probably see that, but I've got the cover on. Probably not. So front is Surefire M600 for my weapon light, and the rear is my laser. Primarily when I'm using my weapon light, obviously I just use the front button when I am rocking my laser under nods. For you guys that don't know, I actually have a new PVS 31's White Foss on the way. You know, L3 just released these to civilians, which is cool. I just recently sold my White Foss new DTMVSs just because I like the PVS 31 housing and just the way those are a little bit better. But once again, Surefire up front and rear laser. Primarily, when I'm running my PEC, I just use this push button here, and if for some reason I need to switch rifle hands to the left, I'll then use this button here, the Mod Light. The rail, all right, this rail was like $440. I remember that price because I paid for it. I was like, ah, darn, a rifle or a rail that had cost money. It sucks, all right, it costs that much, but I love this rail. It's super bulky, which is what it is, but it's iconic. I love the way it looks, full pick all the way around. I went with the FDE, and it's super sturdy, all right? Bomb proof. I wanted something that my PEC could sit on and never lose zero. I wanted something that I could rip full auto. Not that I do that. You know, 200-300 rounds really quick and not have it completely heat up. I was teaching a class where I let everybody use my night vision and everybody came up with 20 rounds and they just blew through ammo and the rail, the suppressor was beaming red, but that rail never got too hot. Foregrip, $75 Knights Armament. Foregrip here, call this a broomstick. I had one just like it in the Marine Corps, so I went with it. Of course, the style of this rifle is FDE, so that's what I went with. I went with an FDE one. Up front here, holding my QD for my sling is a IWI 45 degree offset QD sling swivel. All right, that's just holding my QD here. The sling that I'm using we'll go over later. I think it was like 20, 25 bucks. I just like my sling just kind of out of the way and farther back. You'll see how I rock my sling here. Right there, and then right behind my loft folder by the buffer here. So I don't use my slings up here. Maybe do another video on that later. As far as the mount that I'm using for my optic, this is a ScalarWorks 193 Leap T2 mount. Very, very sturdy mount. You'll see that with my LPVO, my EOTech Voodoo 1-8 that I just recently got a couple months ago, I use the ScalarWorks mount as well. A little expensive, all right? People might think they're too much, but if you're serious in this game, you definitely want a good mount with your optic, all right? This is a $800 optic, so I'm not gonna put a $22 mount on it. Bomb-proof mount, bomb-proof optic. Optic I'm using is the Aimpoint T2, all right, 2 MOA. One of my favorite optics when it comes to red dots, it's either between this and an EOTech EXPS 3-0, two of my favorite red dots, but for this rifle, especially with night vision, and just overall, my go-to battle rifle, I went with the T2. Magpul backup iron sights, this is the Pro. Just kind of taking up space here. You know, do I need backup iron sights with an Aimpoint and a ScalarWorks mount? Probably not. Still waiting on something I ordered a while back will allow me to have a front iron sight in front of the PEC 15 here, but more on that later. Charging handle is a Radian Raptor LT. It's a cheap charging handle. I was looking for a charging handle for this rifle, put up something on Instagram a while back, just looking to buy a Radian Raptor. And Josh Lowley over at T-Rex Arms is cool enough to send me one of his used ones. He probably had a box of 50 or something. So thanks, Josh, appreciate that. As far as it comes to the barrel, all right, the barrel is a Ballistic Vantage 10.5. So once again, I did not say this isn't really a Mark 18, all right? They're supposed to have 10.3 barrels. What's the difference between a 10.3 and a 10.5? Not much. I went to put a 10.3 barrel in here. Gunsmith said I needed a different gas block because this one was too wide or the width or something. So I just said, screw it, throw my 10.5 barrel in there. I didn't want to buy another gas block. Speaking of gas block, I can never say this correctly. Superlative Arms, this is their adjustable gas block. It is so smooth. This rifle is so weird, not even tuned or anything, just runs so smooth. The other thing I do want to eventually do to this rifle is get the Radian charging handle that has the holes in it that's like good for the suppressed gas and blowback and stuff like that, but it's really not overgassed and it's really smooth, which I really, really like. Now, arrow upper, arrow lower, nothing crazy there. Bought both of those, went with the FDE, and this one's black. You know, painted it at one time and it's all worn off, so it kind of gives that worn look, and this rifle has seen some rounds. So arrow full auto bolt, once again, nothing crazy, don't need a crazy expensive bolt, so that's the arrow full auto bolt in there. As far as mag releases and safety selectors, I don't do anything crazy, more or less. Stock's fine for me, the regular AR-15 M4 style. I do not like the 45s for some reason, I'm just an old school kind of guy, and I like the 90s, so I don't need anything special when it comes to that. Now, when we talk about the trigger in this gun, this is the AR Gold trigger. All right, they did send this to me. The first time I found out about this trigger was when I had it in my Zevcor Elite 16 inch. It's my favorite trigger. I think it personally shits on Geissele's trigger. Just love it. Shoots really, really fast, but you can also really get out and get real accurate with this thing with the take up. So as you can see, I could sit there and just kind of slam it to the wall there. All right, take up, there's the break. All right, so really, really like this trigger. AR Gold, American trigger. This is their flat face, really, really like it. Mags that I usually use in, just primarily P mags, never had a problem with them. When it comes to the grip I use, I've got some big hands, so I went with the Magpul K2 XL grip. This one's in gray, couldn't find one in black, so I probably should just spray paint this. I keep saying I'm gonna do it like every day and I never do it. So when I'm done with this video, I should just walk over and spray paint it real quick. Charging handle, we're good. All these were good. Let's talk about the law folder. So really cool when it comes to bags, if you want to throw your rifle in a bag and carry it in a bag like these Vertex bags, or really any bag, a law folder is pretty necessary. All right, I wouldn't go with any of the knockoff law folders you're seeing on the market, but Law Tactical has an awesome, awesome product called the Law Folder. So if you guys are looking to basically, if you haven't heard about these, where have you been? Probably under your bed, I'm just joking. They're awesome. So Law Tactical, Law Folder. They're sweet, and if you wanna have a folded brace, or excuse me, a folded rifle, that's what you need. When it comes to the buffer, just a regular style buffer tube, I don't even know. Magpul STR stock, once again. The favorite stock. If I had to pick a stock just to use on all my rifles, like I already do, it's the Magpul STR. So this is the stock that I'm using on all my rifles right now. I really like the cheek welds, how they're bumped up. I like the thicker, beefier stocks personally. I don't like the real small, minimalist stocks. It's just kind of how I roll. So Magpul STR. Comes to the sling, all right? This is the T-Rex arm sling. Did not pay for this. Guys over at T-Rex Arms sent me a couple of this, Drew and stuff. And I really, really like these. They came out with them, I think, last year, and they're just awesome. I've used this one a ton through classes. I've never had it fray or break or anything like that. I really like how easy it is to manipulate, you know, tighten, loosen. So Derek over at T-Rex Arms did a great job. I did melt it with my suppressor somehow, and it's holding up nicely. So great job on that sling. So that's it, guys. That is all it is when it comes to my Mark 18-ish rifle. All right, once again, not a true Mark 18, but this is my go-to war rifle. This is my bedside gun. This is the gun I set next to the bed. Especially, once again, when I talk about why I choose maybe the T2 over the EOTech is I don't want to have to turn the EOTech on. Yeah, you can keep them on for a long time and, you know, have to return them on, but the batteries don't last as long. This rifle I want, you know, eventually my son to be able to pick up if need be, not have to adjust the optic and not have to worry about batteries. You know, my wife, she might need to get to this rifle, and I don't want her to have to turn the optic on. So it stays on all the time. That way, in the middle of the night, it's already set to brightness. So if you turn that weapon light on, everything's good to go, and you'll see your dot, and everything's zero. If you're wondering what zero I'm using in this gun, it's a 5200, and I'm running, I think, 75 grain Hornady soft point ammunition in this bad boy. So it's a good rifle. It's awesome. It's never failed me, and I like it a lot. Hey, once again, you know, you might have some of these toys. You might have night vision. You might have night vision. You might have a Mark 18 like this, but at the end of the day, if you don't know how to use it, it's not cool. So make sure you know how to use it and get out of the tree. Take it easy.